After nearly 20 years of violence, Afghan leaders and the Taliban were meeting face to face, adamant to defend their agendas behind closed doors in Doha. However, the people in Afghanistan remembered their dear ones who lost their lives in the decades-long violence perpetrated by the Taliban and other terror groups. We have a report.
These families of the victims of a 2018 suicide attack in Kabul gathered at the graveyard of their loved ones and called for a lasting peace as Afghan government officials and the Taliban hold talks in Doha to end 19 years of war in the country. At least 34 students were killed and 56 more were wounded during the attack on August 15, 2018. As the students were preparing for university entrance exam in a classroom at the Maud Academy in West Kabul, where many members of the city's mainly Shiite Hazara community live. Investigators said the bomber entered the center from a rear entrance and made his way into a classroom where more than 100 students had gathered.
به یک شرط می بخشم که کشور افغانستان همیشه آرام باشد. کشور دیگه جنگ بس کنه دیگه. ما یک لغمه نان پیدا میکنیم. کار غربی میکنیم. دیگه بس کنه دیگه. ولی از خدا دیگه بس کنه.
ما به عنوان یک شهروند افغانستان که به صورت مستقیم و غیر مستقیم از جنگ افغانستان آسیب دیدم، من خوشحال هستم که گفتگوها شروع شدن. و امیدوار هستم که گفتگوها نتیجه بدن. به هر حال تمام مردم افغانستان که امروز از جنگ افغانستان رنج دیدن میخوانی به پایان برسند.
In Doha, the peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban replete with calls for peace from US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo and a host of dignitaries on video link urging a ceasefire. Contrasted sharply with the recent violence on the ground. Just hours after the long-awaited talk started, the Taliban again jostled with security forces for control of key highways in Kunduz. The head of Afghanistan's Peace Council, Abdullah Abdullah, demanded reduction in violence as a priority in a meeting with Taliban representatives.
As one of the topmost issues in the minds of the people, reduction in violence in a significant way, in a way that it is palpable, and also getting to humanitarian ceasefire and hopefully permanent ceasefire.
The Taliban do not recognize the Afghan government and call it Kabul administration, one that is installed by the United States. Some analysts and diplomats have raised concerns that the Taliban is entering talks with the upper hand, as violence has escalated in recent months in the war-torn nation, even as the United States withdraws troops.